Shavy, I thought of a great way we could strengthen our relationship.
We're finally going to make out?
Not quite. I was thinking we should try a trial separation.
Oh.
See, they say that absence makes the heart grow fonder. So I thought, if we spent 2 weeks away from each other, then when we get back together, we will realise just how much we mean to each other.
But Shemshi, we already know we mean a lot to each other. But if you insist, just promise me you'll come see me in 2 weeks.
I promise.
Shavy, you need to get off of your couch.
What's the point, Winder? No one wants to see me.
Look, it's time you got over Shemshi, all right? And since I know I can't convince you, I've brought along a few photos of other single males in Machungwaville. See? You've got Guvu.
Too old.
Fair enough. What about Kanafa?
The cheetah? Lions don't breed with cheetahs, Winder. I want cubs one day.
Oh, then I guess I shouldn't bring up Wolfred then.
Are they really the best you can do, Winder?
Yes. Well, no. I mean, there is one other single lion down the road.
I suppose Simba put you in charge of this little team, Kion.
Hi, Lenny. What are you watching?
The Lion Guard! I'm coming to like this show. I really like the attitude they've given Fuli. You know, the female leopard.
Fuli's a cheetah, Lenny.
Then why did they give her leopard spots?
I don't know. Perhaps the animators thought she'd look better with them. But she's a cheetah.
Shavy, stop living in a mythical world. Cheetahs don't exist. They're like unicorns. They're just imaginary creatures made up to make other big cats feel slow and feel bad about themselves. Like the way horses feel bad that they don't have a horn on their head. Fuli is just a small spotted leopard and there's no such animal as a cheetah.
Hmm, that's interesting. A family of cheetahs just moved in across the road.
Lenny, I remember you from my commentary days. You were one fast lion, you were. You better believe it. I'm the fastest animal on earth.
Really? I hardly doubt you have anything for us cheetahs.
Who are you?
My name is Peponi. I'm Kanava's daughter and I'm a cheetah.
Oh, well, hi, Peponi. My name is the Easter Bunny and I'm a chicken.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Lenny, she's a cheetah, okay? Sorry, Peponi, you'll have to forgive him. He refuses to accept that he's not the fastest animal on Earth.
And how do you know she is? If Peponi was really a cheetah, she could run a lap around the racetrack in less than 4 minutes.
Do you think that you can take me on? You must be crazy. There ain't a single thing you've done that's gonna faze me. Oh, but if you wanna have a go, I just wanna let you.
Ready, Peppa?
Let's do this!
Alright, go! Get off of my back!
I know. If I ran that fast, my fur would probably blow off.
So, how did I do?
Heh, serves you right. Now you have to run all the way home naked to get...
She's a cheetah, Lenny.
Everybody hurts sometimes.
Hey, Lenny. I just wanted to check on you.
Sometimes everything is wrong.
You know, my mum once told me that...
Hey guys!
Peponi, this is probably a bad time.
But it's kind of, urgent.
How so?
Well, I think our new house might be haunted. Did anyone live there before us?
A family of tigers. Before them, I think it was some kind of entertainer.
If you want, I can come blow the house up.
Lenny!
Could you two come and take a look at it? I might just be seeing things.
problem. Come on, Lenny. You're not going to get any faster by sulking. Where's your dad?
At the news station. He's on TV now, actually.
Our top story today. Unduk, the original devil and ultimate ruler of hell, is dead. The cause of death is unknown, but rumour is that Machungwa63 got a new phone that didn't have the app that he used to make Unduk's voice, and so he killed the character off. That's right, Unduk has passed on. He is no more. He has ceased to be. He has expired and gone to meet... Oh, you want me to stick to the script? Alright. Unduk's position has been taken by none other than Scary Clownface. So if you ever find yourself being sent to hell, this is now the guy you need to watch out for.
Hey, I think it was a clown I saw in here earlier.
Who, Scary Clownface?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
What's wrong?
What's wrong? Heh, he's a devil, Peponi. You can't outrun him.
Lenny, try and be a little bit more helpful.
Okay, okay. So what's the deal here? Is he just appearing in visions, walking around the house, or what? Boo!
Nope, that.
Yeah, I would say your house is haunted.
I can't believe the Tigers didn't tell us about this. Dad paid a lot of money for this house.
I don't think the Tigers ever knew Peponi. They lived here for years. If it had been haunted, they would have moved out well before now.
What do you two mind staying at least until Dad gets home?
I don't mind. Lenny?
Sure, I'll stay. Perhaps then I can work out where these leopards are getting their speed from.
Thanks, you two. Make yourselves at home. I need to go upstairs for a nap. It's been a busy day moving in.
Good night, Peponi. Lenny? What are you doing?
Research on Scary Clownface. We're prisoners of an insane leopard, Fairy. The sooner we figure this out, the better.
Well, I admire your motivation.
You said the owner of this house before the Tigers was an entertainer, right? Well, what if it was Scary Clownface? I mean, Unduk was the original devil, so at some point Scary Clownface must have been immortal.
Wow. Yes, I suppose you're right, Lenny.
The problem is, every time I type up Scary Clownface, I get information about the devil, rather than about his actual life.
Well, maybe he had an actual name when he was alive. Perhaps he's only taken on the name Scary Clownface since he died.
Boo!
Oh, Lenny, stick a TV back on. He's all over the news. We might be able to learn something there.
Our top story tonight. Shere Khan the Tiger has come back from the dead. The tiger was seen emerging from a cemetery earlier this evening and has already begun terrorizing the people of India as he and several other zombie tigers are invading the local villages.
Boring!
No, Lenny, this is huge. Shere Khan was an evil tiger and he's been dead for years. Yet on the day hell gets a new ruler, all of these tigers have came back to life.
Your point?
Scary Clownface must have sent these tigers out of the gates of hell and back onto Earth. But why?
Perhaps he didn't like them.
Perhaps. Lenny, if you were Scary Clownface, you know, a clown, what would your name be?
Scary Clownface?
No, Lenny, your name before you died.
Oh, well, it could have been Bonzo.
Okay.
Or Bingo.
Uh-huh.
Or Bozo.
Lenny, is there a reason all the names you're giving me begin with B and end in O?
All clown names begin with B and end in O, Sherry. Boo! Go away, you stupid clown!
No, wait, Lenny, that's it. Boo!
Oh, don't you start doing it too!
No, Lenny, his name. I bet his name was Boo. Search it.
Boo, Boo. Aha, here we are. Boo the Clown was an ill-mannered clown who lived about 20 years ago in a house not too far outside the Feral City. Late in his life, Boo changed his name to Scary Clownface, but was killed 2 months later in a fight with a tiger.
Scary Clownface is afraid of tigers.
What makes you think that?
He never haunted this house when the tiger family lived here. Then when he took over hell, he sent all the tigers out of the gate so that he didn't have to deal with them. Come on, let's go and tell Peponi. I have a plan.
I hope this plan of yours works.
Eh? You tricked me! This house isn't owned by tigers at all!
No, it isn't. But those tigers are good friends of his family, and they'll keep coming back if you keep scaring them.
Who were those tigers?
I see we're at a crossroads here. Why do you need to haunt this house anyway? It amuses me. And what about sending Hell's Tigers back to Earth? Surely if you're scared of them, you could just turn them into something weak or flimsy, like a Chiba.
Hey,
that's not a bad idea. Very well, I shall return all of the tigers to hell and turn them into cheetahs. As your reward, I will stop haunting this house.
Really?
But before I go... Boo!
Hey, he's gone.
Oh, thank you, Lenny. Now I can finally sleep in peace.
No problem. Enjoy the rest of your night.
Thanks.
Wow, you have really changed a lot tonight, Lenny. I'm impressed.
Thanks, Sherry. But it's you who deserves credit for the plan.
Well, thanks. But, Lenny, before you go, have you ever had feelings for another someone?
Not until tonight.
Do tell.
I think I may have a crush on Peponi.
Oh.
I've only known her for one day, and already I've seen her naked and spent half a night in her house. Do you think I'd get pepper sprayed if I... Sherry?
This is when you know they've run out of creative ways to destroy my house.
You know where this flight is headed to, don't you?
Nope, I don't know, and I don't care. My boyfriend left me, no one else in town cares for me, and my house is destroyed. I'm just ready to start a new life.
Oh, I never left you, Sherry. I just forgot my phone wouldn't work out of this country, so I could never get back in contact with you once I began taking these flying lessons.
Shemshi? You're a pilot?
In training. Sorry I wasn't able to get back in contact with you. We were out of the country last week and our flight back was delayed several days due to the weather. I was always thinking about you. You ever been inside a cockpit before?
No, but I do like movies about gladiators.
Ever seen a grown lion?
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.